Hey honeys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be showing you an eyeshadow tutorial using the Naked 2 palette, and this was actually a requested video from my friend. And I'm going to be showing you a really easy way to do your eyeshadow for a going out look. Of course, right now I have on my foundation, blush, bronzer, things like that, and my eyebrows on, so I'm just going to be focusing on the eyes. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and all the information about what I use, what products I use, will be listed in the information bar below. And so if you want to see how to get a really easy going out look using the Naked 2 palette, just keep on watching. Okay, so I'm going to start by doing two things before I begin my eyeshadow. The first thing being to prime my eyes with the Tarte Maracuja Concealer, which I always do. And don't forget to set that with some translucent powder. The second thing I'm going to do is optional, but it's best to do this before you do your eyeshadow if you're applying fake eyelashes, or if you just want a blacker eye around your eye line, and that's to tight line underneath the eye. And for that, I'm using the Makeup Forever gel liner. It's way better to do this before your eyeshadow so that when you're pulling up on your eye, you're not messing up your eyeshadow. Okay, so now that we have those two things done, I'm going to go in with the first color in the palette, and that color is going to be Foxy here on the end. And I'm going to place this all in my crease, you know, up to my brow bone to kind of make that my transition color. Next, with a MAC 217 brush, this one's a little dirty, but it's kind of the same color on it, I'm going to be taking Tease, which is this matte color in the middle. And I'm going to be putting this in the crease as well, but I'm actually going to go down on my lid in the outer corner as well. So placing this color on the outer third of the eye and into the crease. The next color I'm going to be taking is Snake Bite, which is this more shiny brown color. And I'm just going to be depositing that into a little more precisely into my crease and the outer corner as well. So more softly and more precise. Next, with a clean blending brush, I'm just going to go in and just blend all those colors that I just put down out so they're going in a little more seamlessly. Next, to darken all this up and really make it a going out look, I'm going to take Blackout and put this in the outer corner. Now, this is the part where we are going to do a little trick. So what I'm going to do is take the pigment with a MAC 217, which I have a fair lot of pigment on this. Is this a MAC 217? Yeah. And then I'm going to pull out my eyes slightly, as even as I possibly can, and I'm going to just put this in the outer corner, and not being too careful, but I'm just going to bring it from the outer corner out toward the end of my eyebrow, toward, of course, my finger and my ear. And then I'm just going to bring it up in the crease slightly. So stretching it out and getting all that pigment in there. But really be careful to not go like even close to the middle or inner part of your eye. And this is what it looks like, which looks crazy, but we're going to fix this in a minute. I'm going to do the other side first. And now you're ready to go out. Just kidding. So now we're going to take a makeup wipe and clean this up. So before I filmed this video, I decided to put on my foundation and stuff, but then I thought about this and I wouldn't have put on my foundation beforehand if I realized that I was going to show you guys this. So I would recommend doing your foundation or doing your eyeshadow before you do your foundation so that you can do this trick and not have to go back in and refix your concealer and stuff after. But what I'm going to do now is, looking at the shape of my eye, so looking at where my eye ends and looking at at where my eyebrow ends and creating this angle, kind of from like the tip of my nose to the end of my eyebrow. And I'm actually going to just sweep the makeup wipe up to clean up that edge and completely give that angle and clean it all up and make it more of a smoky cat eye look. So if you can see right now the difference between this eye and this eye. Then I'm going to do it on the other side. Just easier to swipe down on that side. And voila. Now we're going to fix it up a little bit. So like I said, I would have not done my makeup or my foundation and concealer beforehand and powder and stuff, but I'm just going to like clean this area up with a beauty blender first. With what's left on my beauty blender, because there's still concealer, foundation, all that stuff on it anyway. Just going to clean that up. Now, I'm going to take that fluffy brush again, and I'm going to just even all this out. So up here, it's coming up a little bit too high, so I'm just going to blend that. It's going to blend that down, and you're still going to blend it out slightly. Because we don't want that harsh line that we just created to really appear. We still want it to look blended into the skin. So just blending the edges ever so slightly. And there you go. So that's what they cleaned up and then blended out a little bit. So as you can see, it's more of a cat eye look. Now I'm going to go ahead and do the bottom lash line using almost the same colors. I'm not going to use that transition shade, but I am going to use the other ones that I used. So again, I'm going to go with Tease, the one next to it, which is Snake Bite, and then a little bit of Blackout as well, just to connect the outer corner, but not too much. Now with Blackout, we're literally just going to connect where we pulled the color with the bottom lash line. All right, so that is it for the actual eyeshadow look. Now I want to show you two different things. I'm going to do one eye with just eyeliner and mascara, and I'm going to do the other eye with a false lash, because I want you to see the difference that a false lash does make. And not saying that you have to wear false lashes, I just want you guys to know that a lot of times when you like a makeup look, it's probably because you like the way the lash looks. And, you know, not saying that you don't like the eyeshadow, but if you are trying to replicate a look and it doesn't look the same, it's probably because of the lash. So I'm going to do one eye, just mascara, and one eye with a fake lash. Okay, so as you can see, this is the eye with the lash, and then this is the eye with just mascara. And here it is in comparison side by side. So I also went ahead and obviously put on some lipstick, and I put on some highlighter as well. But yeah, this is the finished look. Of course, one with lashes and the other with just mascara. I think both are great, and it's whatever you're into. If you want to see how I apply false lashes, I will link the video just up here so you can watch it. And if you have any questions about anything I did today or anything you saw, just let me know, leave me a comment or send me a message, and follow me on Instagram and Facebook, whatever you'd like. And I hope everybody has an awesome day. See ya. And don't forget to set that with some translucent powder.